Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I am honored to be here at the Aspen Institute's Award, naturally at the Plaza Hotel, the Rocky Mountains of Manhattan. I am honored and pleased to say a few words about Lynda Resnick. She is my friend, she is my colleague, she is the emergency contact on my Soul Cycle membership. Of course, you know that I know Lynda through our shared passion for pistachio nut. A passion that brought us serendipitously together on the set of the Super Bowl commercial she paid me to be in. But then I don't endorse just any product unless I believe in it 100%. Which is why I have repeatedly refused overtures from the Humane Society. You can't fuel me. Animals don't need money. Lynda Resnick, she's a good nut. Just look what she's accomplished in California's Central Valley. Her generous contributions have helped completely revitalize the rural community of Lost Hills. So much so that I understand they're changing the name to Found Hills. Fun fact, before I forget, did you know pistachio nuts are naturally trans fat free? With 3 grams of fiber per serving, and that doesn't include eating the shells. You eat those things, they will sweep you clean. They are nature's broom. Speaking of coming out of its shell, the community of Lost Hills. But back to pistachios for a moment. Did you know that you would have to eat 2 whole plums to get the same fiber as 1 ounce of wonderful pistachios? Right, I'll just clear my whole afternoon schedule to eat 2 whole plums. The arrogance of the plum industry. I'm sorry, I'm just really passionate about pistachios. But we're here to talk about Lynda Resnick. Did you know she also grows pomegranates? They're an antioxidant-rich superfood that also happens to be delicious. In fact, I like to think of Lynda's POM Wonderful pomegranate juice as the pistachios of fruit juice. Now, I know what you're thinking, and no, I am not being paid every time I mention the word pistachios tonight. And as for the rest of Lynda's wonderful almonds, halo mandarins, and sweet scarlet grapefruits, so red and juicy you'd swear you were biting into the summer sun itself. Well, I don't do those ads. Yet. But Lynda knows that none of these miracles of nature would be possible without the Central Valley communities that cultivate them. And that's why she has dedicated herself to cultivating the communities in return. Just look at Lost Hill's newly renovated park, which has become a community hub, hosting activities like Zumba, martial arts, cooking, and English lessons, sometimes at the same time. And folks, you have not lived until you have seen a black belt perform demi-pliés while deboning a chicken in the past perfect tense. That's the difference that Lynda is making in this community. But nowhere has Lynda made more of an impact than in education. She has helped create 2 preschools, a high school, and this year alone helped fund 17 special summer academies for students of all ages, giving these lucky kids what all children want, school in the summertime. And thanks to Lynda's generosity, over 100 scholarships are handed out annually to graduating seniors with mentoring programs to give them the skills they need to succeed in college, which I know is the ability to throw a ping pong ball into a red Solo cup. So ladies and gentlemen, and wonderful people of every nut-loving orientation, in recognition of her passion, vision, and tireless advocacy, the 2014 Aspen Institute Corporate Leadership Award goes to, I'm so excited, I'm shaking. Yes, Lynda Resnick, Lynda.
Thank you, darling. Thank you.
Beautiful.
Good evening, everybody. I've grown a lot at the Aspen Institute, but not in height. Could you bring out my step? So you can see this dismembered voice, who it's coming from. Stephen, isn't he brilliant? You think I'm kidding. Anyway.
I follow her everywhere with that.
I have no pride. Anyway, Stephen's fantastic, and I guess it takes a nut to sell a nut. What do you think? And two of the commercials that Stephen made for us this year were voted funniest commercials of the year, so we just loved working with him. I can't tell you how much I appreciate this Corporate Leadership Award. I want to thank the board and the senior leadership of the Aspen Institute. It's so humbling, really, to follow in the footsteps of luminaries like my hero, Leonard Lauder, Dick Costello, David Rubenstein, and to share the stage tonight with the visionary founder of Netflix, Reed Hastings, and the Henry Crown Fellow. It's humbling, but I still told everyone I know. I must first express my sincere appreciation for the Institute and for Walter Isaacson. Walter, you've been called an expert on genius, and I say it takes one to know one. You and the Institute have inspired my intellectual and philanthropic awakening, and I know it sounds maudlin, but it's really true. Walter says that vision without execution is just hallucination. Isn't that a great quote? You've got to have a team of people who have great visions, but you also have to get people that can do the job. Can you think of a better man to be CEO or a BFF? I can't. When Stewart and I return from Aspen every summer, we're charged with a new spirit of change for all the brilliant thinkers and bold visionaries that have inspired me through these years at the Institute, like David Brooks and Tom Friedman and Jeffrey Goldberg and Michael Sandel and Jacqueline Novogratz and Madeleine Albright. I share this with you, but I'm going to keep it at my house for a while if you don't mind. It's amazing the intense focus, the right perspective that corporate resources can do to serve a higher purpose. Corporate leadership means more than just making profits, as you know. It means reinvesting those profits into social programs that inspire others to take the reins, that offer empowerment and a way to a sustainable future. Einstein said that if he had 1 hour to save the world, he would spend 55 minutes defining the problem and only 5 minutes finding the solution. To all the corporate leaders in this room, I say, this is our hour. I believe that we must commit ourselves now to setting a new standard of partnership between the private sector and communities. When you approach philanthropy like a business, it is not just imposing your goodwill on others, but doing the appropriate research and listening intently to your stakeholders like a good business does. Only then can you succeed with programs that create change the way a good business creates dollars. If the collective acumen in this room applied its skills and resources towards social issues, we could lift all the ships like a rising tide, or better yet, we could lower sea levels. As the pressure in our society becomes more challenging, the urgency to help grows. We may not all share a common past, but we certainly share a common future. I often remind myself that it is just sheer luck and privilege that put me where I am today up on this stage. There are many who are smarter than I am and who work harder than I do. But I had the luck and good fortune to be born into a family that could feed me and put a roof over my head and educate me. And billions of people in the world don't have that same privilege. I hope this award inspires others, corporate business people, to take action and to make even more positive change and lasting hope in the world. I promise you that the ROI is indescribable. Thank you for this recognition. I'm enormously grateful, but I have to thank the most important shout out of all, which is my husband and partner of 42 years, Stewart. Without you, darling, none of this would be possible. I assure you that we will continue to work every day to be worthy of this. Thank you so much.